All right, so today for this video at least, we're going to discuss arc length. The next video is going to talk about curvature, and then there's something else we're going to talk about, the normal vectors, which I alluded to earlier. When I say earlier, I mean a couple of videos ago when we talked about the tangent vector. And there's also one more sort of new type of vector we're going to talk about, but that's another video. So I'm going to try to keep these videos to be as short as possible for you. Anyway, arc length. Our goal is to determine the length of a curve in either two dimensions or three dimensions. So if we have a curve defined by parametric equations, x equals f of t, y equals g of t, where t is between a and b, including the endpoints, the arc length is given by the integral from a to b of square root of f prime squared plus g prime squared. You probably saw this in Calc 2. Maybe only just in passing, but. So similarly, the arc length of a vector valued function r of t is equal to f of t plus g of t, f of t times I plus g of t times j is given by, wait for it, same formula. So again, we're assuming obviously between the points A and B. And if we have a three-dimensional vector valued function, you can guess that the arc length of the curve is going to be pretty much the same. We take f prime squared plus g prime squared plus h prime squared, take the square root of that sum and integrate from a to b. Notice that in both of these formulas, really the integrand, the thing we're integrating, is just the magnitude of the tangent vector, right? We have this for the three-dimensional case, we have the square root of f prime squared plus g prime squared plus h prime squared, but the tangent vector is what? F prime times I plus g prime times j plus h prime times k, and we take the magnitude of that, well, there you go. Therefore, we may write the formula for the arc length of a smooth curve C defined by a vector valued function r of t, where t is in the interval AB with the endpoints included. We can simplify that formula, and instead of thinking of multiple formulas, just think of the formula that S being the arc length is going to be the integral from A to B of the magnitude of r prime of t dt. So let's use this in an example. Let's determine the length of the parameterized curve r of t, whose components are 2 times t, 3 times sine 2t, and 3 times cosine 2t. And we want that arc length on the interval of t greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 2 pi. So first of all, we find r prime of t, right, the tangent vector. And that tangent vector is just going to be the vector with components. Derivative of 2t is 2. Derivative of 3 sine of 2t is 6 cosine of 2t. The derivative of 3 cosine of 2t is negative 6 sine of 2t. All right. And what's the magnitude of that vector? Well, the magnitude is just going to be the square root of 2 squared plus 6 times cosine of 2t. Quantity squared plus negative 6 sine of 2t. Quantity squared, which gives us, well, 2 squared is 4. And we get 36 cos squared 2t plus 36 sine squared 2t. And we can write this as 4 plus 36 times cos squared 2t plus sine squared 2t, and as we know, cos squared plus sine squared is 1. So this really gives me square root of 4 plus 36, which is equal to the square root of 40, which we can write as 2 root 10. So my arc length is then going to be the integral from 0 to 2 pi of this quantity 2 root 10 dt. So I get 2 root 10 times t, evaluate at the endpoints. I trust everyone can do that. If you have any questions, let me know. But we get 4 pi times the square root of 10. Now, before we depart, because in case you're thinking, dang, she was right, that's a really short video, we want to take a look, at least a quick look, at one more concept here, and that's that of the arc length function. And so we define the arc length function for a smooth function, r of t. Recall, smooth means r prime exists and is continuous, and it's r prime is not zero on our interval. Anyway, define for t greater than or equal to a, and we're going to define it from the equation of arc length. So it's given by s of t. And so instead of having b as our endpoint, we're going to have t, and we're going to introduce a dummy variable for our variable that we're using for integration. Let's just say u. So we have s of t is the integral from a to t of the magnitude of the derivative evaluated using this parameter u du. So first thing to notice, if I take the derivative ds dt, that's just going to be the magnitude of r prime of t, which we know is greater than zero. And if the derivative of a function is positive, the function's increasing. So s of t is always increasing. If the magnitude of my tangent vector is equal to 1 for all t greater than or equal to a, then that parameter t just represents the arc length from the starting point t is equal to a. Oopsie daisy. Now you might ask, why do we want to define this? I mean, that seems like extra work. It turns out that we can use the arc length function to derive another parameterization of a curve C, and that's called the arc length parameterization. And what's the benefit of arc length parameterization, right? It's like extra work, right? No, with the arc length parameterization, we can always tell where we are on the curve after we've traveled a distance of s along the curve starting from t equals zero. Let's look at an example that will hopefully illustrate that. Let's determine the arc length parameterization for the function that we just looked at. So that vector valued function, t greater than or equal to zero. So for any t greater than or equal to zero. All right, so from the previous example, we already did some of the work, so let's not reinvent the wheel. From the previous example, we have that r prime of t's magnitude is 2 root 10. So our arc length function then is going to be s of t is going to equal the integral from 0 to t, 2 root 10 ds. And if you do the integration, you're going to get 2 times square root of 10 times t. All right, so next what we're going to do is we're going to solve for t as a function of s. So t is going to equal s over 2 root 10. And then r of s gives the arc length parameterization of r of t, so of our vector valued function. So specifically, we get r of s is equal to the vector with components, s over square root of 10, 3 sine of s over square root of 10, 3 cosine of s over square root of 10. Just plugging this value for t back into our function. And that's how we define it. So not a whole lot of extra work really from what we've already done. So that's our answer. Let's do a follow-up question. Let's note that Professor made a slight typo. Where on the curve defined by that vector valued function we just looked at, are we after we travel a distance of pi root 10 over 3? Since we have the arc length function, we just need to evaluate r evaluated at that pi root 10 over 3. So we just need to evaluate r of s at s equals pi root 10 over 3. So r of pi root 10 over 3 is going to be first component is going to be just pi over 3 because the root 10s cancel. Second component will be 3 sine of pi over 3. And the third component is 3 cosine pi over 3, which will give us the vector pi over 3, 3 root 3 over 2, and last component is 3 halves. And that's it. All right, so for the next video, we are going to discuss curvature, a very important topic. All right, I will cease recording. Have a great day.